So then you got your new bar, maybe you upgraded to some nice carbon bars. If you do put them on, make sure they weren't upside down. So I didn't notice, my buddies noticed and they started giving me a bunch of crap for it. So this is good. So these bars have a little bit of a, they call it a back sweep. So they're actually coming back towards me a little bit. So you do want them coming back towards you. You want that horizontal. You don't want these sticking up in this direction. You want them to curve so it's about horizontal with the ground. Of course, we're lining up the center here the best you can. What I like to do is, if I'm doing this by myself, holding it with one hand here, getting my faceplate here, I'll probably go ahead and stick one bolt in there, just like that, and make sure that these bolts have some grease on them as well. So as I'm holding, I'm gonna come do all this with one hand, get that bolt started, boom, then I'm pretty good. Then if I need to, I can let go and go and get the rest of my bolts. And then I'm gonna go across here. Doesn't matter the pattern you start them, but good rule of thumb, we're gonna be going back and doing a pattern when we tighten. So just making you aware of that, get all these started. And I like starting the screws. Any screw you do, you put on, whether it's on your bike or your car or something in the house, always start it by finger. Get at least 2 revolutions in, then you know it's the proper fit. Then you can come back with the tool and go nuts. Important thing with these, there's a gap between the faceplate and the stem. There's a gap top and bottom. We want equal spacing from the top gap and the bottom gap. They should be the same. You don't want one side touching, pinching, and then a huge gap on the other side. All that does is create stress on your faceplate, and at some point it's going to crack. So got a slight gap here, and then you're gonna have to take a peek. You definitely have to get your eyeballs down there. Yeah, so I got a pretty good gap there. And right now the bolts are getting pretty firm, just finger tight at this point. Double check your gap, got spacing there. It's probably about 2 millimeter gap. 2 millimeter gap looks good there. And then you can go back, make sure that your bar is nice and center. Again, if the bolts are a little bit tight, you can loosen 1 or 2 bolts or more if you need to. Like that'll do it right there. So some systems are easier to line up the bars. So again, we're going back towards me. There's no rise going upwards. Some bars kind of go like on your motocross bars. This does not, this is considered a flat bar. Pretty common for cross-country racing stuff. I'm just looking at the lines on both sides. Either a little bit, just a hair is showing on each side, or it's completely not showing. And then we're getting our tilt angle correct. If you have to, this is where you would get off your bike. You would stand back, get down eye level at your handlebar, and look straight across to make sure that your angle is either too high or too low or just perfect. But this is something you can go back, and once you get everything buttoned up, if you find that it needs a slight adjustment, it's not a big deal. Just loosen this faceplate bolts a little bit, do your tilting, and then you're good to go. So I like that right there. So I'm gonna go ahead and start. So it doesn't matter which one you start with to tighten. We're gonna do tightening probably about 3, gonna go by at least 3 times, if not more. So we're gonna tighten that up just a little bit, like I turned. Then I'm gonna come up here diagonally, across and over on top, tighten that a little bit. I'm gonna jump directly across to the next bolt, tighten that, and I'm gonna go across diagonally to the bottom, tighten that guy. So that's one round right there. So I'm gently bringing up the tension. I don't wanna do everything all at once. So kinda go back to that first one you started at, tighten a little bit, and this is where you would bring out your torque wrench. And I think I messed up my pattern, but as long as you keep jumping around and try and follow something, you're okay. So I'm gonna get my torque wrench out. And like I said, on this stem, these are marking, there's a marking here, here, or here, telling you what to tighten it. If you see 2 numbers, like a 5 Newton meter and then a 4 over here, then you need to abide by that. If this one says 4, then you're tightening these 2 bolts to 4. This one says 5, you're tightening these to 5. If I only see 1 marking, like on this one here, you gotta look underneath too. This one says 5, I'm gonna do 5 for everything. Faceplate and the clamp stem bolts. So 4 millimeter, I will set this to 5 Newton meter. And we're gonna tighten. We're gonna try and keep that pattern. So tightening, that clicked right away. So I'm either right on spec or I'm a little too tight. And I'll jump up. So I surprised myself, I was always over tightening bolts until I got a torque wrench. So to me, these seem on the light side, but hey, we're gonna go with that. So these are all pretty tight. I'm gonna go by one more time. You'll know it's tightening more is when you feel it turn and tighten and then it clicks. This one clicks and then it kind of gives. Gives it a little bit of a free turn. Boom. I'm gonna get a grip on the outside here, grip it hard, and I'm gonna try and twist forward. And we'll be able to do this again once we get our grips on. So far, tightness on this faceplate seems really good.